Thank you. is mentioning me. Hallelujah.
I'm very happy Easter continuing to you all here. A very warm welcome to you and to those watching at home as well. Easter goes on, so you keep saying hallelujah as long as you're not. So, I don't know, we don't get notices now, do we? No, because I'm
not
going to be here.
Christ, our Passover Lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil, and professing our sins with a sincere and true heart. Most merciful God, Father of our Lord
Jesus Christ,
we confess that we have sinned in all our eternity. We have not loved you
with our
whole heart.
We have not loved
our neighbors as ourselves.
In your mercy, forgive what we have done. Help us to remember what we are.
And direct what we shall be. That we may do
that. Love mercy.
And walk
humbly with
you, our God.
Amen. As you are, the Holy Lord, and so you repent, have mercy upon you, and pardon and deliver you from all your sins. And pardon and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
It was done, and then to sing the Gloria to the words on the screen rather than on your book. Almighty Father, you have given your only Son to die for our sins and to rise again for our justification. Grant us so to put away the leaven of malice and wickedness, that we may always serve you in pureness of living and truth. Through the merits of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first reading is from the Acts of the Apostles. The whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions, of everything they owned was held in common. The great power of the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them and bought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each of any household.
The second reading is from the first letter of John. We declare to you what was from the beginning, what we have heard, what we have seen with our eyes, what we have looked on and touched with our hands, concerning the word of life. This life was revealed, and we have seen it and testified to it. We declare to you the eternal life that was with the Father and was revealed to us. We declare to you what we have seen and heard, so that you also may have fellowship with us. And truly, our fellowship is with the Father and with His Son, Jesus Christ. We are writing these things so that our joy may be complete. This is the message we have heard from him and perform to you. God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we say that we have fellowship with him while we are walking in darkness, we lie and do not do what is true. But if we walk in the light, as he himself is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. If we confess our sins, he who is faithful and just will forgive us our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. If we say that we have not sinned, we make him a liar, and his word is not in us. My little children, I am writing these things to you so that you may not sin. But if anybody does sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous. And he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. And not for ours only, but also for the sins of the whole world. It says the word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Christ is risen. He is risen
indeed.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John. When it was evening on the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nail in his hand, I put my finger in the mark of the nail, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." And he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Last week, Penny and I went to London, and as we were going along, we suddenly met Prince William and George, and I only recognised it because we were like a pair. We were trying to be incognito. Well, that's not so. It's not April the 1st, but I made it up. Fake news. Probably just as well. And we kept taking some of the pairs quite a lot at the moment, doesn't it? And it's very hard sometimes to know exactly where the truth lies and what the truth is. And whenever I hear politicians say, "Of course the truth is," I wonder, are they right? Or the fact of the matter is, that's not a good one. Maybe not. Now, of course, having fake news and getting things wrong is not a new phenomenon, or at least larger than news, because right through history, the winners have always written history, so you always get that slant on things. And actually, you could argue that a lot of the Old Testament about that too. So the slant, of course, is a slant. The slant because of what they believed in and because of their history, bound to be a slant. So to get to know what the real facts are is not easy. And we all know that if somebody witnesses an accident, and you get three people witnessing the same accident, you probably get three long different accounts of what happened. It's very difficult. And the truth, what is the truth, is a real question. One of my favourite books, right beside this, for the younger ones in the congregation, they might be, it's probably out of print now, but we read this to our children quite a lot longer. "Why are there more questions than answers, Grandad?" And all like that. I'll just read you a little bit because it's Could you have a narrow line behind a broad brow, Grandad? Does a flying fish need a pilot's license, Grandad? Can a centipede touch all its toes, Grandad? How many sides has a balloon, Grandad? Anyway, it goes on. It's a great book, great book. Lots and lots of questions. And of course, Thomas had questions about what the other disciples said they'd see. And perhaps a cynical approach isn't so bad. But was Thomas cynical, or was he just questioning? Well, we don't know, but I think he was sceptical and questioning. And I go with that. I don't really go with the idea of doubting Thomas, because doubting Thomas sort of puts him over there. Well, it's like a second-rate disciple, because he doubted. But I don't go with that. I go with the idea that he was questioning Thomas, I think, is a better adjective, because Thomas questioned, and questioning, I think, is a good thing. There's a famous picture. Not in Grecian, but basically it's by Caravaggio, who is an amazing painter. There was a picture, I just mentioned this as an aside, there was a picture of an Aspen gallery, which I always go to see whenever I go to the Aspen gallery in London. And Caravaggio is a road to Emmaus, and Jesus is with the two disciples, and he's just about to bless the bread and disappear from them. And his hand almost comes out in the painting. It's extraordinary. It's amazing picture. But anyway, I think that there's a bit of fake news up there. I could say that. But because we're not told that Thomas actually put his hand into Jesus' side. Thomas's response was the most amazing declaration of faith, perhaps in the whole of the New Testament, my Lord and my God. After that, he put his hand in. He responded in that way. No doubt, to parents, maybe not necessarily, or Thomas to do it, but even so. One of the greatest statements, as I say, was the New Testament. And I like to think that the opposite of faith is not doubt, but certainty. After all, I know for certain that. I know for certain that 2 plus 2 makes 4. Okay? I don't need to believe it. It's certain. So, belief and certainty are different things. The opposite of faith is certainty. Are you believe or it's certain? What you don't. Sometimes they all fall down and they get it all wrong. But I'm not so sure. You get various, there are some Christian sects which have certainty. Here it is. This is what you believe, and this is what you sign up to. That's it. And if you question things, then there's lots of nasty things that happen. You might get sent out away from your family. Your family might disown you. You might lose your job. Now, if you don't believe me, read the wonderful book by Rebecca Stott called In the Days of Rain. An example of that actually happening in this country. It could happen. And it's dangerous, I think. Be careful of things for children saying they are certain because they haven't. Ask any questions. At 8 o'clock, at 8 o'clock this morning, as I was saying, 8 o'clock, at the end of it, a lady came out and she said, we went to a Catholic school and I asked questions and I got into terrible trouble. Well, I think asking questions is the right thing to do because. How do we grow and develop in our understanding unless we have always been things? Unless we ask some questions. On a very trivial level, when we're little, I expect we have a picture of God as the old man up in the sky with a beard. And that may work at that age. But it doesn't work later on because we find out in our about science and we discover things, and we know it can't be quite like that. So we question it, and we get a better model, a more greater understanding of what the nature of God is like. We're never going to know it completely. It's like it's in a sense of mystery, of course. We can't possibly know the mind of God. But we can begin to grapple with it and get them. We see through a glass darkly, St. Paul says, but we do see. Okay, we do see. And we get those glimpses, particularly across at this time of Easter. So I think they Paul ask questions. It's good to ask questions, because that's how we develop. Paul's questioning sent me to India. So we think probably around Goa, and there we set up a church, and I think it's true to say that the motto of the church now is in that same tradition of Thomas. All churches in India and in many other parts of the world too certainly came across the motto of the church in the Middle East. So, what with Thomas, since after 2,000 years, his influence, his questioning, his exploring, his faith has grown into a wonderful thing. And then, of course, we've got the other fantastic picture, I mentioned that kind of idea, the road to Emmaus. I like the road to Emmaus as well because not only was Jesus revealed in the bread and wine, and the world is coming into communion today, and the understanding the reality of Christ in us, as it were, but also as they went along the road, their hearts burned within them. I love that phrase. Jesus was telling them about what was going on, and their hearts burnt within them. Now, it's not just a matter of the head. Questions are important, but it's also a matter of the heart as well. Of knowing that it's going to work, and you know it's not just in your head, but in your guts as well. It's a lovely expression. You know what you know. You know what you know. So, I think both are important. It's totally rational, you've got to try to question it. But it's not just about reason. It's about your heart and what you feel in the very depths of you. So where does faith come into this all? I was talking to the six-holders many years ago, and I remember this, it stuck in my mind. The six-holder said to me, if everybody believes in something, I thought, yes, they're right. Everybody believes in something. The question is, let's make a choice about what it is we believe in. To be human, we want to believe in something. Something beyond us. That's the only kind of paintings. In very early times, people wanting to express something which was beyond them and just search for something more than what they were. We've always been curious. We've always wanted to know more. We've always had this feeling that there is something bigger than us. And Christians, we believe that following Jesus Christ is the way to live fully, to live human lives, to love God the way we are, and our neighbours as ourselves. That's the way to live an authentic life, something similar to eternal life. We believe that not only in our heads, but in our hearts and guts as well. Jesus said to Thomas on another occasion, I am the way, the truth, and the life. We believe that Jesus is the way. And from that, questions come as we explore more and more about what it means to live that authentic life in Christ and see the world in the light of the resurrection. May we continue to see things in the light of Christ with our arms open, our hearts burning, and our first question.
Let us stand and with our hearts and minds declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We believe in one God, Father, the Almighty. Maker of heaven and earth, and all that it is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, turn to the God of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. He got him
not known, and one given with the Father, knowing him all for his own end. And I, and Father, have salvation, who came down from the Holy, and who incarnate from the Holy Spirit, and the Virgin Mary, and the Lord's name. I ask that if he was crucified on the front of the planet, he suffered death in his veins, on the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures, he was ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the heavens and seas. The Lord the giver of the Lord, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son in voice and glorified, who has spoken through the prophet. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the Lord.
In the power of the Spirit, and in the union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. Lord, when you came to earth, you became human that we might dwell in the divine. You died that we might rise to life immortal. Help us to live as those called to believe, serve, and trust in you. Lord, in your mercy, create a God we pray for the world, where people long for justice, freedom, and peace, but where people are hungry, homeless, and destitute. We pray for the known aid agencies striving to support and enable others. We remember all those affected by the earthquake in Taiwan. May you do what you can to feed and care for others. Lord, in your mercy, let you remember before you places and places where there is violence and killing. We pray for those who have fled that violence and now seek a new life. Under the guidance of your Holy Spirit, help all people and leaders with power and influence to put aside bias and prejudice so we may become more compassionate and less caring and ill. Lord, in your mercy, we God is praying for your church, that we, your followers and friends, may be filled with the Spirit of the living God, resting with new life and enabled to feed the physical, emotional, and spiritual hunger of people around us. We pray for Bishop Rachel and Bishop Robert. For Rachel, Ian and Alan and their ministry and members in this parish, and for all who lead our worship. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for our neighbors, friends, and families. We pray for those who are ill in body and mind, who are anxious for a friend. We pray for all our prayer families who are ill at this time, remembering particularly Carson, Tony, Richard, and Margaret, that they may be strengthened in spirit and feel your comfort and love for them indeed. Lord, in your mercy, Loving God, we pray for those who have died, and we now look forward to the life and peace of your kingdom. We remember the time of seven aid workers here at the Garden. We commend to your everlasting care those who have died and those who remain. And we remember through the group, Sally Rose, Jennifer Lacey, Keith Burston, Rita Morgan, and Karen. Let our group mind, Rick Smith, Albert Cole, Derek Jones, Colin Watkins, Ron Wilkins, and we are the people. Lord, in your mercy, gracious God, bring your resurrection life to the sinners that wonderful world. Rebuild in us whatever is real. Reclaim in us whatever is destined. Mercy the Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, and the Savior of Jesus Christ.
Risen Christ came and stood amongst his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." And they were glad when they saw the Lord. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Thank you.
to the God by whose grace creation is renewed, by whose love heaven is opened, by whose mercy we offer our sacrifice of praise. Lord, be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
Lift that to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks to
the Lord. We indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father. And in these days of Easter, we celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell, and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise, and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so, in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. Holy, 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 God of power and love, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Granted by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, whose gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Through the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave him thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat. This is your body which is given to me. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took his cup and gave him thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ is alive. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup. And we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup. And that we, in the company of Mary, the mother of our Lord, the apostles, Thomas, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen. As our Savior taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art
in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine
is the kingdom, power and glory, forever and ever. Amen. Every time we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. For nearly 10, the save the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was gave for you, and his blood, which was shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance, which was died for you. And feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Lord, O God, you will take away the sins of the world and the rest of the world. Lord, O God, you will take away the sins of the world and the rest of the world. Lord, O God, you will take away the sins of the world and the rest of the world. Thank you. through our Savior Jesus Christ, we have assured your children of eternal life, and their baptism has made us one with him. Deliver us from the death of sin, and enable us to new life in your name, in the first and in the Holy Spirit, by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And pray together. Father of all, who give you thanks and praise, that when we must still fall off, you let us in your strength and in your strength. Find the living who declares your love, give us grace, and open the gates of glory. May we who share Christ's body, win his living light. We who drink his cup, bring life to others. We who the Spirit lights, bring light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
follow. The Spirit of truth brings you in also to rejoice and confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and strengthen you to proclaim the word and works of God. And blessing is on the Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And we hear this day, this Easter time, as we love and thankful and remain with you always. Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.